This lesson's learning intention is that hopefully by the end of it, you will understand that light can be refracted when it encounters different surfaces. The success criteria for this lesson is that by the end, you will be able to define the refraction of light. You'll be able to calculate the angle of incidence and the angle of refraction using scientific diagrams, and you'll be able to explain the relationship between the angle of incidence and the angle of refraction. Now we're going to look at a property of light that's called refraction. So refraction means the bending of light. So have a look at the pen on the left in the beaker. If you're looking through the glass, the pen looks the same all the way along. You can see where it's out of the glass, you can see it coming in, and the picture of it is not distorted in any way. But if we then move that pen and place it into water, so you can see the level of the water just there, it now looks like the pen is slightly bent. And actually it looks like it is larger in the bottom part where the water is compared with the top. The reason for this is because water, when light hits the water, it bends it. It causes the light to change direction. And that's why we don't see the image as a true image, as what is actually going on there. We can see the property of refraction of light by looking through a glass prism. So here you can see the beam of light is traveling in a straight line here, all the way down the page. If I then put this glass prism in line of that light, that beam that was originally going straight down here has now shifted. We can see that there is a little bit of the light has been reflected. Okay, you can see that beam there. But this beam here has been refracted. So rather than traveling straight through here, there's actually a bend in the light. And here you can see the exiting beam going in this direction. Just like when we were looking at the angle of incidence and reflection, we can also look at the angle of incidence and the angle of refraction. So I'm going to show you how to do that now, and then you can do some practice ones yourself later. So just like the last time, we are going to mark on our page where everything was set up. So I'm going to draw a line to show where my light box was and where the incident ray starts. I'm going to trace around my glass prism. I'm going to show where the light hits the prism. I'm also still going to show the reflected beam. And I'm going to show the refracted beam as well. Now that I've done those things, I can remove my equipment and label the diagram accordingly. So just like we did last time, I've labeled my light source. I'm going to rule my lines. So this was the incident ray. So the arrow again shows the direction the ray was coming from. So from the light source to the glass prism. Okay, and we're going to label it as incident ray. Okay, and then this was our reflected ray. And here is our refracted ray. All right, now between the incident ray where it hits the glass prism, and we can label this as our glass prism, to where it matches up with the refracted ray, we're just going to put like a little dotted line through. It also helps us to see that it's not passing through as a straight line. There is actually a bend here at this point here, and again when the light leaves the glass, again it bends in another direction. So now to work out what the angle of incidence is and the angle of refraction. So similar to when we did the angle of reflection before, we need to draw in our normal, and the normal is always at 90 degrees to the surface of the medium that the light is hitting or passing through. So I'm going to set up my protractor here where the incident ray meets the glass prism, and at 90 degrees I'm going to draw a line. And the angle of incidence is the angle that the incident ray makes with the normal. So this in here is the angle of incidence. Now the angle of refraction is this angle here. It's the angle that is made between the refracted ray and the normal. So in this case, let's measure it up. So here we have that the angle of incidence is 33 degrees and the angle of refraction is 23 degrees. Now we can also, so this is where the light is hitting the medium, we can also look at it when it is exiting as well. So let's have a look over here. Again, the normal is at 90 degrees to the medium. So I'm gonna set up my protractor right at the point where the refracted ray exits the medium this time. And I'm going to mark my 90 degrees. So this time, the angle of incidence is that of the light coming through the medium here. Let's just call that I for now. And this is our angle of refraction here. Angle of incidence this time is 23 degrees. Angle of refraction as it leaves the medium is 33 degrees. Now hopefully you can see the relationship between these different angles. Okay, so the angle of incidence as the light is coming in to hit the medium is equivalent to the angle of refraction as the light leaves the medium. Likewise, the angle of refraction as the light passes through the glass prism, 23 degrees, and the angle of incidence as it's on its way out of the medium is 23 degrees.